Hello, everyone, and welcome to Clarity Night for August. Okay, I have some stuff. Meena is saying, Isha, I'm outside. I cannot show my face. No problem, Meena. I get that. Chetali is telling me that she can't hear. Chetali, can you hear me now? Awesome. Okay. It's so funny. I have my alarm set for 7 o'clock. Let me just quickly put it off before it goes off again. Okay. So first of all, to start off, I must say that mom is on her way and she will be joining us as soon as possible. Okay. Until then, we can get started. So I'm really excited for this month's topic, which is business and debt. Have fun. Now, I want to ask you one thing. When you heard debt, what is the energy that came up with it? Did your world expand?
Became icky.
Yeah. Why is that? A lot of times, maybe also like Gary and Dane say, because debt has the energy of death. Debt and death have a very similar energy.
Yeah.
So every time you say, I am in debt, you're saying, I am death. I'm dying. The energy of my finances are dying. My life is dying. Everything is coming to an end. And that's the energy that you're putting out there. So even though you want to create and generate all these wonderful things in your life, have you ever wondered why a lot of times you can't? It's because you're operating from the energy of death rather than the energy of actualization and creation with total ease. So a quick tool that Access has been giving us is, instead of calling your debts debt, call it your past expenditures. Mm. It's a totally different energy. It's not an energy of burden. It's not an energy of lack. When you say, I am in debt, you're just like lack and lack and lots of lack. So, everything that brought up, right, wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, online shorts, boys and beyond. Okay. So, I would like to start with asking, I mean, I have already started, but I would love to ask you guys, what are your definitions of business? Business, money, what is your definition? And by the way, they're not the same things. I know a lot of people mistake business and money as one and they glump it into one thing in totality. So everywhere we all have misidentified and misapplied business and money as one. Can we destroy and create that? Right, wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, online shorts, boys and beyonds. We also a lot of times believe that the only way to create money in our lives is through the business that we do, whether it's a job, whether it's a business. And by the way, your job is also your business. A lot of times people ask this question, okay, fine, yes, job okay, business okay, but what about the people who are actually have a job? And your job is your business too. If you go into your job energetically with the energy of being under someone, under the company, under your boss, you will not be willing to outcreate yourself. You will not be willing to outcreate your business. You will not be willing to outcreate your boss. So everywhere you have been working in your business as a job, this goes for everyone. Can you please destroy and create that? Right, wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, online shots, boys and beyonds. What about non-financial debts? What do you, can you give me a little more clarity about that, Jyotika? Like being indebted to someone because of something that they did?
Yeah, or something they gave you at a time where you could not have bought it, maybe, or did something for you, or a financial contribution to you.
It's, can I just say, it's so wonderful to hear your voice again. It has been a while.
Yeah.
It is so wonderful to hear your voice.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh. Give me a second. Okay. Okay. So yes. Okay, guys, can I please request you all to put yourselves on mute? Apart from the time you would like to ask a question, then please feel free to unmute yourself. But if you're not asking a question and not having a conversation, can I please request you to put yourselves on mute? Just the moment. And at any moment, if you want to ask a question, go ahead and put yourselves off mute, okay? Okay. So, being indebted to someone, like Jyotika is asking, wonderful question. What about the moments we feel we are indebted to people? Whether it's because of something we decided that they did out of kind. Okay. So this is great. A lot of times, let me ask you a question. See if it's true for any one of you. Is it any time that you feel that you're indebted to someone, could it be a beyond for you? Could it be a possibility that you never thought you would ever receive something like that, or anyone would offer something like that to you?
Yeah.
Which is why you went into a beyond. And then you decided that you had to be indebted to the person because it was too good to be true.
Yeah.
Everything that brought up. Can we destroy and uncreate it all?
Yes.
Right, wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, online shots, boys and beyond. All the definitions of debt we are using. Can we destroy and uncreate all of that?
Yes.
Right, wrong, good and bad, pod and pock, online shots, voice and beyonds.
No, what is coming?
Us choosing to be... Yes, yeah, sorry, go ahead.
No, you go. You. You go ahead, Isha.
The voice is cracking.
I say you go ahead.
Okay. So what I was asking was, could it be a possibility that being indebted to people had something to do with our receiving, our unwillingness to receive?
Yeah. And other things, yeah, the way it was given to us.
The way it was given to us.
So it was difficult to receive, but you had to receive at that time. Like if you couldn't pay for a certain study and someone paid and it was given in a very, the energy of it was not good, you took it, but right. Then that indebtedness, and eventually as you were thinking or just being aware in that moment, one thing came was that debts, do they finally lead to death of relationships? Whenever you feel indebted either financially or
you know.
I'm just
seeing a pattern. What do you know, honey?
Yeah, I'm seeing a pattern. Yeah. That's what came to me, that eventually then the issues start. Whether it is financially you feel indebted or others, right? Eventually the scenarios create where the relationship goes into depth.
Yes. So, you know how we spoke about the energy of debt is actually the energy of death?
Yeah.
Whether it's with your finances, whether it's with your relationships, whether it's with anything at all. If you're going, if you're moving forward with the energy of being indebted, you are literally inviting death.
Yeah.
Into whatever it is, whether it's your relationship, whether it's your business, whether it's your family, whether it's money.
Yeah. Big awareness there. Big awareness.
Yes.
Another,
yes.
And another point is that, you know, when you don't acknowledge what you are contributing to the other person, and you keep on contributing, it's never enough from your side. Although you've done so much.
So let me stop you there and ask you, whose projections of enough are you using to create all of that? And whose points of views of enough are you using to choose the not enough you are choosing?
Yeah.
Everything like that is getting destroyed and uncreated all.
Yeah. I guess
right, wrong, good and bad. Pod, online shots, boys and beyonds.
I guess I took you on a detour. Please continue with the financials.
No, no. This is a fabulous conversation we are having. And what else is possible? Go ahead, please. All of you, how much do we all discount our awarenesses and how much do we all discount our questions? Like, please don't do that. Everything that we are doing to discount ourselves, can we please destroy and uncreate that? Right, wrong, good and bad, broad and bulk, online shorts, boys and girls. I'm just going to guess you said a yes.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yes. Okay. Awesome. Did that give you more clarity on relationships?
Yeah, relationship and death versus receiving. And, you know, and if you continue to feel indebted, eventually you are inviting death of that thing and issues in that area. And eventually, acknowledging and honoring your contribution to others.
Summary. Absolutely. And yet not making it a conclusion.
Yeah.
There's a very fine line in acknowledging all of that and deciding and concluding that that was it and full stop. There's an energy of a lot of heaviness that steps into it when you decide that it's great, wonderful, etc., etc., and all of that. And then it just becomes heavy because you've decided it's the greatest it can be or it's the worst it can be. It just becomes really heavy. What if you could receive with total gratitude and caring and kindness and ask what else is possible from here? If someone is truly willing to contribute to your world, are you willing to receive their contribution?
Yes. Yes.
And everything that doesn't allow all of us to receive everyone's contribution who are willing to contribute to us and who are waiting to contribute to us, can we please destroy and uncreate all of that?
Yes. Isha, it was alive and I said yes.
Shots, boys and beyond. You? No way.
So I want to do a course and someone is ready to gift me that course and it's heavy to receive.
Yeah, so how much are you willing to receive you and how much are you willing to receive contribution from you? So everywhere you are unwilling to receive you being a contribution, can you please destroy and uncreate that?
Yes. Yes. Hello.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Awesome. Let's talk about definitions. The next question that Simran has asked is, definition of business is of something that is structured, organized, process-based, and such boring words. I know, right? So boring, so stuck. And responsibility. I know I read responsibility somewhere too in the chat. Someone had said, Meena, business means responsibility. Yeah. Yeah. So all the definitions we are using to create the business we are choosing, can we destroy and uncreate that? Right, wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, online shots, boys and beyond. Jyotika saying, thank you, great awareness opening. Thank you, Jyotika. That is phenomenal. Yeah, so the thing about definitions, anytime we define anything as true and real and significant, have you ever wondered when you get into something with the adventure of it, the energy of it is so expansive. But the second you define it as correct, real, that's what's going to bring you, get you to success, etc. All the wonderful things that we define it, or all the wonderful, not such wonderful things that we define it. Have you ever wondered that the energy gets stuck right after that? You get into this adventure of having a lot of fun. There's a lot of adventure. There's a lot of expansiveness, a lot of ease. There's a lot of lightness. And then you define it to be correct, to be etc. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. And then it becomes stuck. Or else you grow up looking at your parents. You grow up looking at your family. You grow up looking at all the different people who project what business is. And then you buy their definition of business as yours, and you try to duplicate what they created, and it never works out because that is their reality and not yours. And everything that is bringing up, can we destroy and uncreate it all?
Yes.
Right, wrong, good and bad, pod and pork, online shots, boys and beyond. Welcome, Mama.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, sweetheart. So sorry I'm late. But I see you guys are having fun. Jyotika. Lovely to see you too, Jyotika. Oh, I don't see you, but where are you?
She's here. They're all right awesome. Here. Neera Anjali also said, hi, Chandana.
Hi,
long time.
Beautiful.
Charu.
Simran.
Hi, Neera Anjali. She's saying hi.
Yeah,
awesome. So we were just talking about, oh, look at that. Thank you, guys. Mom walks in and all your videos come on. Really? So good to see you both together. Yes. So good to have you here.
Hi, beautiful Chota baby. We have a little one who's ready to clear her. Change of financial reality at this stage.
And contribute to our financial reality.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. So in fact, I don't know what you guys were talking
about. We were
about.
Actually just talking about definitions of business.
Okay.
And I was just asking them, how many times do we grow up? How many times do we grow up looking at people around us, looking at our families, looking at you have to give us a second.
Yeah, now I'm comfortable. Okay. Yes.
How many times do we look at everyone around us and decide what business is, and we pick up all the definitions from them and try to biomimic and try to duplicate what business was for them, deciding that that is what is going to bring us to success.
Yeah.
But it never truly works out because that's not our reality.
Yeah.
That was their reality that created for them. So everywhere, the definitions we are using to create the business based on other people's definitions. Can we please destroy and uncreate all of that?
Yes, please.
Right, wrong, good and bad, pot and pork, online shorts, boys and beyond.
And on the same note, let's talk about actually, So on the same note, let's talk a little bit about, events. You know, I find this really interesting of late. I've been noticing that what have you defined events as? What have we defined? What emotions have we attached to events? Like, you know, when a something like we need to know some people, right? So it's like when we have when a certain event takes place, which brings up a lot of joy of or ecstasy or excitement. We kind of, every time a similar event comes up, we attach the same amount of conclusion to whatever's happening now based on the event that was in the past. So what have you defined events as in the past of your life that you find yourself creating in this reality, consciousness. Everything that is, you destroy and uncreate it all. Right and wrong, good and bad, pot and pot, all nine. And how many conclusions have you already based on the new businesses that you're choosing to create, based on the past events of how such businesses showed up? Everything that is, and all those connection points that you have attached to the past, attached to all those events, can you please destroy and uncreate it all? Right and wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, all nine shots, boys and beyonds. Just speaking a little bit more about this, what if you could look at all those events that had you defining good event, bad event, good business, bad business, lot of money, no money. Exporters have a lot of money, but when you're supplying in the Indian market, you don't make the money, right? These are all points of views which are based on certain events that happened. So all those little things, all those small little things, are you willing to destroy and uncreate all of that? So there are no connection points left. There are no definitions left. Right and wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, all nine shots, boys and beyonds.
Cool. So I got the book right here. Are you sitting on it?
No, which book?
Oh. I got this wonderful book.
Yeah, it's
money is not the problem. You are. Yeah. I got this wonderful book. And you know what the tagline is? It says, what if it's all about how much you're willing to receive? What if it's not about the money coming to you? What if it's not about how much money is willing? What if it's really not about other people giving you the money, other people paying you the money? What if it's not about all of that? What if it's just about the willingness to receive money? Notice I didn't say willingness to earn money. Are you willing to truly receive the money people are willing to give to you, irrespective of how it shows up in your world?
And from where it shows up.
Yes, and from where it shows up.
Right.
Are you willing to receive it? And everything that doesn't allow that, can you destroy and uncreate it all?
Yes, please.
Right, yes. Wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, online shots, boys and beyond.
So I had a really interesting one, something that, you know, I was driving back. That's why I got a little late. I was driving back. And something that just popped into my universe was, how often have we maintained scorecards? Scorecards with our business, scorecards with money. I mean, this was more in my universe. It popped up about, I was sitting, like, you know, I mean, how much do we maintain scorecards in relationships? Right? I mean, I have done this for him. Has he done this for me? I did that for her. Did she do this for me? Has she done enough or am I doing too much? How much of scorecard are you maintaining with your business? How many expectations do you have that has you constantly maintaining a scorecard that has you disregarding what your business is actually gifting you? Everything that is, can you destroy and uncreate it all? Right and wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, all nine shots, boys and beyonds.
I want to read out this little chapter from the book. We are jumping topics because there's so many. I can get all the questions that's in all your universes.
Yeah, right.
That you are picking up. Puck,
yeah.
But like, whatever this call asks for, we are willing to go there. Okay. So there's this topic. It says, I can't afford it.
Ah, that one.
That one. So I'm going to read it out. Have you ever told yourself, I can't afford this? Years ago, I was working. This is Gary talking. Years ago, I was working at an antique shop, rearranging furniture for them. Ritu's nodding ahead. They hired me because every time I rearranged things, something they had in stock for 2 years would sell. They'd have me come in and do a rearrangement about every 2 weeks. I was making $37.50 an hour, which was pretty good money at that time. I was doing that along with everything else I could do to support my kids and my wife. The shop owners were so happy with that, with what I was doing. They said, you know what? Anything you want to buy at the store, we'll give it to you at our cost, and you can put it on terminal layaway. You can have it whenever you get it paid off. Just keep working for us. This was not a low-end antique shop. This was a place that had $20,000 bedroom sets. They had diamond rings that were $35,000. I looked at them and said, who can afford this stuff? After they said that to me, I looked around the shop and suddenly I realized I could have anything in it. So how much have we discounted people's willingness to gift to us, irrespective of whether it shows up as money or anything else? How much have we decided that we have to work our butts off to actualize everything we truly would like in our life? What if it's just the willingness to receive? What others and are willing to give to you? And that would include yourself, the universe, the elementals, and everyone within it. In it, with it, and everything that doesn't allow that to show up, can you destroy and create it all? Right, wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, online shorts, boys and beyond.
Do we have any questions here?
Not as of now.
Anybody with a question, guys? Hands up.
Or pants you can just down.
Unmute yourself. Or pants down. But then the camera has to be on. Yes, Charu.
So, I have a question. As I had messaged you sometime back that my work is affected, and then you asked me whether it is affected or changed, and I had the awareness that a lot of change is happening through around me, in me, and whatever. But to stay with that, what else can I create here? And then there is a blankness. And then in last few days, when I'm saying that now I'm choosing to honor myself, so there are people whom I'm saying no, that I'm not doing this because somewhere it is becoming dishonoring. And that is like in the linearity, it looks like work is getting affected. I'm saying no to clients who are not honoring my time. And though I have that awareness that it is changing, but to keep up with that energy, there is a struggle going on within.
Okay. Yeah. So, yes.
So the question, I'm not sure, but it's like, how do I, it's not even how, but something where it's, though I know the change is happening, when I ask questions, nothing is showing up right now.
Have you asked, is this the time? You know, have you seen...
Is this the time?
Have you seen the lull before the storm? Right? I mean, would you define that as a wrongness? It's not a wrongness, sweetheart. It just is. We are so used to all the time constantly having to do something that when we are just being, we go into the wrongness of ourselves. Right? What if your body, what if your universe, what if everything in you has changed so much? When you did message to say that your work is affected, and it was like, is it affected or has it changed? And you said, oh yeah, I didn't realize it's changed and how much is changing now. So what if you actually start to look at, hi, what if you actually start to look at how much has it changed and how much is it changing that my body, my being requires this time? sometimes it's just things are just shifting so fast that on the surface you feel you're not doing anything, but underwater you have to keep moving your legs or you'll drown. Right? Is that what's happening in your reality, darling? Is that it or is it something else?
So what I'm observing is that work has changed and it has changed drastically. Like,
yes.
It has just changed. I don't want to define it also.
Wonderful. Please don't. Yeah.
But immediately what happens, like in linearity, it's the money which is getting affected.
Yeah.
Affected or what? Money is not showing up right now.
Okay.
And then, can I ask you a question, Charu? I'm sorry, I'm cutting you off.
Go ahead.
So, you know, I was listening to the SOP class recordings again this morning. Of course, I was jet lagged. I slept at 3 o'clock in the afternoon yesterday. And woke up at 2 o'clock in the morning, not realizing where I was. So what do at 2 a.m.? Switch on the Symphony of Possibilities recordings. So I started listening to them. And in that, Dane had said that if you're asking, you know, I heard you saying that I've been asking a question, but nothing is changing.
No, I'm asking questions. But I get that blankness. I'm aware that there is a change happening.
Right.
But when we don't define it, then it becomes like, okay, like I start my day and I don't know how it is going to go.
Oh.
He's looking for it.
So you want to define it while being undefined.
Sorry?
So you want to define your day while being undefined.
Yeah, that's easy, right? So why don't you run this one, darling? What have I defined as being undefined? That has me choosing definition to finally be the undefined. To be the undefined. Right and wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, online shots, boys and beyond.
Can you please?
No, I don't remember it. What was it? I don't remember. You'll get the replay. Run that for yourself, because what you're looking for here, honey, is to define the change.
Yeah.
Yeah. When you are looking to understand the change, is you looking to define the change? Right? So what if you could be so undefinable? So undefinable that you could no longer recognize yourself.
But are you ready for that?
Oh yeah, bring it on. And everything that doesn't allow that, sweetheart, can you please destroy and uncreate it all? Yes. Right and wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, all nine shots, boys and beyond. Yeah. Run that for yourself, okay?
Yeah. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay. Hi, Dibarti. She's asking, hi, Isha. What was the thing you were telling about SOP Dane? Right. So what I was saying was, so I was hearing the recordings, and in that he said that, you know, if there's any moment, any time, any aspect area in your life where you're constantly asking the question, but it doesn't seem to be changing. You're asking a question, putting it on loop, playing it on loop, but it's not changing that situation of yours. That situation seems to be the same. Dane said you might want to ask a different question. It might actually be a conclusion you're operating from, that this is what is going to change this situation of mine. You might want to change the question and ask a different question. It's like say for instance, I've decided that my what example can I give? Okay, I've decided that once. It's because if I want to increase my money flows. Yes, Charu, go ahead.
Yeah. So like, for example, I was asking question that, it's not even a question. I was saying my work is affected. My work is affected.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
It's like a lot of discomfort. Yeah. And a simple question which you asked was, is it affected or has it changed? And the whole space shifted for me. Okay. And then with that change, there is a lot of discomfort, which we all know that sometimes change is not very comfortable. And just staying with that discomfort, where all I have defined that discomfort as discomfort, and I was just clearing that. So that is where I remember that Dane saying that we may want to ask a different question.
Yes. Yes. Absolutely.
And also another thing that's...
Simran is saying, this reminds me of when you said, if you're stuck in the same place for 6 months, you're hitting at a wall, hoping it will turn into a door.
Oh, yeah. So true. Wow. Yes. Yeah. So also, if when you are not able to change something for a while, guys, you may want to ask, is this even yours that you're looking to change? Because when you're not able to change something, you could be trying to change something that you think is yours, but it never was. So Charu, especially for you, darling, who does this belong to? Return it all to sender with consciousness attached, okay? Yeah.
And I remember that too, Simran. I love the quote.
Yeah, that's a really nice question.
Yeah, you might be operating from what? Oh, you're pulling my plug out of my ear.
Sorry, I think we need to get two different.
We are very conscious mother and conscious parent. Okay, who have no fun together. Okay, yeah. So
can you hear me now, Chubby? I'll hold it.
I won't be able to talk.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So I'm just holding it. Okay.
Can you hear us now? Thank you.
Cool.
Yeah.
So any more questions, guys? Bring it on.
Hi, Chandana. Hi, Isha.
Hi, Kokil.
Hi, Kokil.
Okay, whatever you just said about, like, whatever question Charu raised, could you talk a little more? Now, say, if I'm facing, say, a financial crisis, you know, so how, I mean, I just wanted to talk a little more on this, that it might not belong to me.
The one I love to run is, what energy, space, and consciousness can I in my body be to change my financial reality with complete ease?
Okay.
And can I also ask, you know, I really love the way you asked your question. It's so amazing. And you said, can you talk about, it's like you have the awareness, you know it, that it's not yours. You knew that, oh, you know, can you talk about it more? That it's, you know, that then you suddenly said, not being mine. You know, it's not yours, honey.
Yes.
So everywhere you've been making it yours, can you destroy and uncreate that?
Yeah.
Right, wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, online shorts, boys and beyonds. And another question I'd like to ask you is, are you in someone else's universe healing them of their financial reality? Kokil?
Yes.
Yeah. Are you in someone else's financial world healing their financial reality?
Yes.
So all the oaths, vows, commonalities, fealties, commitments, binding, bonding, contracts you have made to heal any and all other beings of their financial realities and introduce them to yours by giving yours up. Can you please revoke, reclaim, renounce, destroy, and uncreate all of that?
Yes.
Right, wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, yes. Online shorts, boys and beyonds. Disclaimer, guys. Healing someone else's financial reality out of unconsciousness does not help. It does not help them. It definitely does not help you. It does not help anyone else either. What if you could inspire them and empower them to change their financial reality instead of you placing yourself in their universe and trying to shift when they are not willing to shift and when they are not willing to have it?
And also, before we move on to the next question, if you can. So whose financial reality are you actually creating your reality from? What if you could just ask who's, it's not even you picking up somebody's reality. It's not even us bio-mimicking anybody's reality. It's more about picking up from where somebody left to carry on so that what he did stays alive. How many of you are running your businesses and creating a financial reality based on how your parents ran it, your father ran it, your brother ran it, your grandfather ran it, and all those stories that you heard about how business should be run, how it should not be run, how it ran in the past, that you are keeping alive even if it's killing you and even if it's destroying your financial reality and your business? Everything that is, can you all destroy and uncreate it all, please? Right and wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, all nine shots, boys and beyonds. And I really would like to ask you a couple of questions here. One is, the first one which I always ask myself whenever I go into a slump where money doesn't come in the way I'd like it to, or business is not doing the way I should like it to.
I should like it to. No expectations there.
Right, no expectations. Yeah, absolutely. No expectations there, right? Not at all. None whatsoever. Yeah. So what I really like to ask is, I've forgotten. Okay, so what I really like to ask...
Did we just pot and pock your expectations?
I think you did. I think you just pot and pock me. So when you look at a business, when you look at anything that you're creating, look at how you started the business. Look at the excitement that you started the businesses. Look at the kind of excitement that you started to change your financial reality with. You made a new project, like Simran out there wrote a beautiful book. Beautiful book which can change people's lives, and she threw it out there, and there's an excitement, and there's this wow, I can do it. And how many of us started so we can actually stop, because we've decided we've already done it? How much of your business, how much of your financial reality is start and stop and start and stop, instead of start and out-create and out-create even more? So everywhere that you're looking to start a business so you can stop the business, everywhere that you're looking for your back door and for the exit doors, instead of moving forward, knowing that that is the only way to create a reality. Can you all please destroy and uncreate all of that? Right and wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, online shots, boys and beyonds. What if the back door was fully shut?
No, but then you'll make too much money, and then it'll be too much fun.
There's too much money. There's too much fun. There are no excuses. Are you willing
to... Can I ask a question here? Hi,
yes,
guys.
Yes, hi, Ruchika.
Hi.
Sure, darling. Go ahead.
Why does there have to be a back door at all?
Why?
Because there might be a better possibility out there.
But then why do you need to go out the back?
That's just
okay.
Yeah.
Sarcasm. Right.
Yeah. A back door is an exit door, which is the excuse you use most of the time not to create. In a business, a back door can be lack of money. In a business, a back door can be pain in the body, which is why you don't go to work. In business, a backdoor may be a difficult father who doesn't let you create the business like you wanted to. What is your backdoor, guys? Recognize that backdoor. What have you defined as your backdoor that you have given so much power to that it controls your business? Everything that is. Can you destroy and uncreate it all, please?
Yes, please. Right, I almost didn't hop onto this call. Right. Sorry. Yeah, right and wrong. Good and
I wonder wrong. Why.
I know it's business.
I was feeling very sick and tired and having all the genuine reasons to just say, the body needs rest. Why don't you just be? Why do you have to just, do another thing? sometimes not doing is better than doing, and I fed myself all that, and then I hopped onto the Zoom.
Yeah. Awesome. Awesome. That's where we resist change, right? You're like, I don't need to do it. No, I'm tired. I'm exhausted. My body hurts.
Yeah. It's like,
how often is that our back door?
It's like, I refuse to receive the bars for the first, I don't know how many months. I was like, nope, no one's touching me. I don't want my bars run. Thank you very much. while having a mother in the house who was a bars facilitator, I was like, nope, you ain't coming close to me.
That sounds very familiar.
And then when I got my bars done, well, rest is history.
History. It's the first time today that I have heard this concept from you, Chandana, about being a passive healer for someone else's financial reality.
Yeah, that's what Isha spoke about. Yes, right? I mean, how much do we do that in families, with the ones we love?
Constantly. Yeah. Exactly. And I knew about being a passive healer, not about that it applied to the financial reality. And somewhere a bulb just lit up and I'm just overjoyed by the fact that I know what's happening to me.
Sorry.
Happening to you or what you're choosing?
Choosing, yes. That's the other part of it. Nobody's making me do anything. I chose it. And when you go about not knowing what you're doing, just because you're not aware of it, it just spins a completely different universe. And I've been spinning there. Thank you very much. Goodbye. I don't want to spin there anymore.
Wonderful.
So grateful to you guys. Thanks.
You're welcome, sweetheart.
So grateful to you.
Thank you, love. We have some more questions.
So, what questions can I ask to engage the elementals in creating possibilities of money? Just that one. What will it take to engage the elementals in creating the possibilities of money? And how about we make it slightly more undefined? What will it take to engage the elementals in creating possibilities?
Greater possibilities.
Yeah.
Right.
And everything that doesn't allow that, can we destroy and uncreate it all? Right, wrong, good and bad, pot and pork, online shorts, boys and beyonds. And you just have to ask. Just ask. Elementals are with you at all times. You are the elemental. You be the elemental. Don't think an elemental is something that's outside of you. But you have to look outside of you to find it. It's not something you have to find. You are it. You be it. Engage it. It's just about engaging your very being. You are not. Don't look. Don't think an elemental. Once you reach the elemental and once you have achieved it, then everything will be perfect. Yes. Everything that is, can we destroy and uncreate it all?
Yes, please.
Yes.
Right, wrong, good and bad, pot and pork, online shorts, boys and beyonds.
Can I ask a question?
Yes. Sure.
Yeah. Hi, my name is Vilma. And hi. Yeah, the thing is, when I actually got into Access, I got my bars run and my mind was all blank. And I got into this creation spree where I was like creating like a maniac, like, you know, creating money, creating clients, creating a lot. And somewhere in between, I created a spiral where there was a lot of slack. And then I started judging myself a lot. And of late, of late, I'm not feeling the energy. I'm not feeling ease, joy, and glory. And even if a client does show up or if something does show up, there is this constant sinking feeling that I keep getting, even though I'm getting my bars run on a regular basis and everything.
There's this really new question that has just been introduced.
Yeah, tell me.
Is it yours?
No, it isn't mine. And I am constantly returning it to the sender with consciousness. However, that feeling just doesn't seem to go. It's like some part of me.
Okay, one moment.
Uh-huh.
What feelings are you using? What inventions are you using to create the feelings that you are choosing that has you creating the unease in your space? Right and wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, online shots, voice, beyond. And also, I would like to ask you said when I started, I had this fabulous, I was creating like a maniac and stuff like that. And now there's no ease, joy, and glory, you said, right? There is no I want to ask you, are you already being ease, joy and glory that you're looking to define it? Because you're already there, you're like, now what? Nothing. This is ease, joy and glory. No, it can't be. What is ease, joy and glory? And then you go into the wrongness of being ease, joy and glory. Everything that is, can you destroy
now? No.
That didn't seem light. No. The thing is that there is this dirty feeling.
Amma, she's not ease, joy and glory. No, don't, please do not say things like glory. That.
Okay. Sorry, Vilma.
Sarcasm. I need my word. Sarcasm.
Okay. I didn't get you. Sorry.
We were pulling your leg, honey.
Okay. Yeah, so like I said, there's this continuous sinking feeling. And even if a client does show up, there's this... I can't explain. It's very uncomfortable all the time.
So can I ask you a question?
Yes.
A couple of questions.
Yeah, please.
So when you got into Access, you said that like, you created like a maniac. It was so much fun. You were having so much fun creating. So how much, how many expectations and definitions of creation did you attach to Access when you started off?
Loads. I thought, I believed it's going to change my life and I'm superb, I'm sorted and wow, now I've got there and wow, amazing, superb, cool.
Yes, and are those the feelings that you're talking about?
And did you start missing the drama of your life?
That is not there anymore because you're truly pot-and-pocking all the expectations, all the projections, all the judgments, and you're truly stepping into being undefined. And as you're being more and more... Okay, one second. As you're being more and more undefined... You don't recognize the space of being undefined, so you're trying to look for the feelings that were there when you started, the expectations that were there when you started. But you're being so undefined that it doesn't match your definitions.
And Vilma, I want to ask you one thing, darling. Have you reached the edge of your box again?
I'm sorry?
Have you reached the edge of your box yet again?
Edge of my box as in?
As in, you were in a box before, which you stepped out of. And you were like, I was creating, I was having fun, I was having magic.
Yes.
But were you still creating within a box?
Yes.
So are you now, is it now time to step out of that box?
Yes.
So what can you choose now, honey, that can have you creating the ease that you be? Right and wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, all nine shots, boys and beyond. I like the way she just gone blank on that. Run that a couple of times.
Is it time? Is now the time to outcreate everything that you've created?
Yes.
Is it time? Is now the time to ask even bigger?
Yes.
And are you doing that? And are you being that?
So I'm asking a lot of questions. However, most of my questions are about getting into a frame of ease because...
Okay, stop.
There's a lot of honeys.
Stop. Did you hear Isha's question?
Yes.
What was it?
What was the question?
Are you asking questions to outcreate? Yes.
No, that was not the question.
Okay, that was not the question.
That was the question. But the question is, are you willing to ask for greater, a step, like 10 steps greater? Are you willing to ask for way bigger than you were willing to ask yesterday?
No.
Yeah. And is that what is required out of you now?
Yes.
Right and wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, online shots, boys and beyonds. Sweetheart, when you outcreate yourself and you still create another box for yourself, you're still in a box. It may be from the size of cage, it may have gone into a shoebox size, but it's still a shoebox size. Maybe now it's time to go into the size of a box that fits a vacuum cleaner.
You could just step out of the box.
No, but no. You have to have a box.
I don't.
No, are you sure? You don't want a box?
No,
you want to be box
free? Yes.
Then darling, ask for that. What will it take for me to be out of control, out of form, out of structure, out of linearity, out of concentricities, with complete ease? With my body, with money, with business, and with my choices. Right and wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, all nine shots.
All nine shots, boys and beyonds.
You know, it's funny because I was asking for some stuff for a year and a half. I was asking to step up and step up and step up. And I had visualized myself and like defined myself what stepping up looked like. And then a few days, weeks back, I was just like, I had decided that I've reached my point of stepping up that I had asked for. I'm just like, now what? Same, that energy that you're talking about, I was in it a week and a half back. And I was just like...
Was it like really uncomfortable? Like, you know, you get up and you feel like, oh my God, I don't want to wake up. I just want to go back to sleep and sleep forever. Something like that.
Is your body tired? Is your body asking for rest?
Yes.
So why, darling, who said resting, if your body's asking for rest, is a wrongness?
It's not that I am giving my body too much angst. I am in a very comfortable place, but it's just that I keep feeling sleepy. I don't feel like getting up. I feel very sluggish.
No, that's the energy of suffocation. It's time you broke free from your box. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah. Mm. Just ask. But she doesn't want to.
You know what?
I do want to.
What if you could just ask for greater now? What if you have actualized everything that you have been asking for and now is it time to ask for even greater?
Yes.
Do you trust you to be greater?
No. Oops, sorry.
Is that the unease?
Sorry.
That's fine.
Everywhere you're apologizing to be you, can you please destroy and uncreate that?
Wow, that's
beautiful. Yes.
Right, wrong, good and bad, pod and bok, online shots, boys and beyond.
Pull this section out and run it for yourself as much as you can, please, darling. Okay?
Yes.
Yeah, this conversation that we just had with you, pull it out and see what works for you.
Okay? And if it's light for you, if at all it's light for you, ask for bigger than you would have yesterday. Even if it scares you, even if it...
Yes, it scares me. It is scary. I'm in a very scared mode right now. Aww.
Is it fear or is it excitement? Truth.
It's excitement.
Oh.
But excitement is wrong. So I'd rather choose fear.
You're right? Excited to create greater. Do not misidentify it as fear. I mean, you could, but then you can ask yourself, is this fear or is this excitement? You know, it's so exciting to ask for bigger than you would have because you're just like, oh my God, I can actualize it also now. Just ask what? Just ask if you'd like to. ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा क्या हो जाएगा? It'll get actualized.
मैं वो नहीं देखती, मैं दवाइयाँ नहीं देखती.
अभी तो आंटी जाती है इशू receive करने में.
हाँ क्या?
I'm saying this happens, you know, but sometimes you just ask randomly, and when it shows up, you are like, what?
Damn it!
It just came. And you know, now I have to receive it.
And I have to receive it. And I am so potent. Now what do I do with that potency?
Right? I mean, was it really possible? And so quickly? Really I have to receive it?
Oh no.
Oh, then the unease.
Yeah. Do that. Do that.
Something I want to say, just I was very incomplete in whatever... I had the question I had. Now, what happens with me is that when I'm hired...
Kokil.
Yeah, Kokil. When I'm hired by somebody,
And most of the times it's people who are in not doing well financially. So I'm hired and they start making a lot of money even after I move on, after completing the project with them. But my financial situation, you know, like doesn't change and they don't pay me too much.
So the thing about financial healing that we did, is it a possibility that you were operating from there?
Yeah.
And are you also the energy of wealth that you introduce into people's realities?
Unconsciously giving away what is you.
Yes.
When you do it consciously, then you don't give it away.
Yes.
So everywhere you're unwilling to get paid for the energy of wealth that you already are. Can you please destroy and uncreate it all?
Yes.
Right, wrong, good and bad, pot and pock, online shots, boys and beyonds. You might want to put the oaths and vows that we ran about healing financial realities on loop.
Sure.
See what that changes.
Yes. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Pleasure.
I think we had a few questions. Let's take some.
Okay.
I think the unease of Charu being... said she wants to know about passive healing.
I think we covered that.
We covered
during,
that, yeah. And Meena too.
I think that was during...
Is that okay? Did you guys get that? About healing people passively, unconsciously, silently. Changing their... Having their financial reality change.
Yes, is what.
Awesome. Cool.
Okay. The unease of being limited, not creating greater that I know is truly possible. Everything that is getting destroyed and uncreated yes. all. Right, wrong, good and bad. Pot and pop, online shots, boys and beyonds. Simran is saying, as soon as you said, do I have to actualize it now? My nephew popped his head up, surprised. Oh, yeah. Like,
is that even possible?
Like,
now?
Who wouldn't want to actualize that? Dude, I'll do it now.
Yeah.
You're not choosing it for what stupid reason?
I want to know who is HDIGBTTS7. Darling, what's your name?
She gave us
how does it get any better?
Hi, this is Debarati. Yeah.
Hi.
Who?
My name is Debarati.
Debarati.
Hi. Yeah, and I did my foundation and all
wonderful.
With Sangeeta.
Awesome. Oh, that's I love awesome. Sangeeta. She's just
yeah, fabulous. Truly. And you know, I just saw your post.
I love her.
Same, yeah. I love her, like really love her. And you know, I'm like so grateful for access and everything. And you know, I just saw your post on Colors of Possibility and I just jumped on this call and I'm like so, so grateful to both of you because you know, the things that you spoke about, I mean, things that I didn't even know that I could actually be a passive healer for somebody else's financial reality as well. So yeah, man, you guys are great. Thank you so much. It was like a first call with you guys. And it was awesome. Thank you,
Chandana, sweetheart.
Isha.
Thank you, darling. Thank you.
For being
and we
here.
Have this every month if you're not in our clarity month in the group.
Please add me. I'll just send you a message on
yes,
your WhatsApp.
Send us a message and we'll put you into the group. Okay?
Perfect.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
You're more than welcome to join us. You're welcome, sweetheart.
Thank you.
Awesome. You're welcome. Any more questions?
Any more questions, guys?
Probably good.
Oh, we are over 1 hour. You just don't know where this hour
Simran
goes on.
Like, uh-oh. They know it's 1 hour over. All right. Thank you, friends, for joining us. Love you all.
What a fun evening it's been.
Thank you, girls. Thank you, guys. Thank you all. Love you all. And
thank
see you,
you
next month. We'll talk more about debt next month. I don't think we had the time to cover debt this month. So we'll talk about business and debt next month. Yeah?
Or bodies. I want to talk
Whatever.
About bodies. What do
Whatever.
You want to talk about, guys?
Yeah. Yeah. Put. Let's see. Whoever puts up the first one, we
Come
do
on.
That.
Bodies
and money.
We both.
Do it, okay. baby. Okay, Chaitali, you got it. Fastest finger first. That's the one, right? Fastest finger first?
Yes.
Oh. Okay.
Fastest finger first.
See you next month, girls. Bye.
Bye. Bharati, not Shefali.
Yep.
Bigre bigre, na it is. My cousin called how does it get better than this? Hegre bigre.
He says yo, hegre bigre.
Okay. Awesome. We shall see you next month.
Bye. Love you.
Can't say bye.